The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... G. Marshall. Woman, said the German philosopher, was God's second mistake. And therefore, the implication should be clear. If the good Lord himself could be mistaken about women, what chance have we mere mortal men? But it was the Irish poet who said it more gracefully. My only books were woman's looks and follies. All they taught me. For the next hour, our subject is woman and equal parts folly and wisdom.
Rachel! Rachel! Wake up, Rachel!
Oh, I must have been asleep.
Rachel!
Whose voice is that?
Rachel! Have you forgotten me already?
Isaac!
Yes.
But they killed you. I saw them kill you.
I've come back to you.
Then it's a mistake. You didn't die.
No, it wasn't a mistake. I died. I did die.
Mystery drama, Queen of the Deadly Night, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Sam Dan and stars Marian Seldes. It is sponsored in part by Anheuser-Busch Incorporated, Brewers of Budweiser, and True Value Hardware Stores. I'll be back shortly with Act One. We are deep in the Dark Ages. It has been 500 years since the civilization of the Roman Empire has been blotted out. It will be 500 more till the world will awaken to the light of the Renaissance. The year 900. A bad time to be weak or poor or a woman, especially a woman. And our tale concerns a woman. Her name was Rachel. She lived in Clairvaux, a tiny village near Paris, which wasn't much bigger than a village itself in those days. She was, of all things, a writer. She compiled stories and legends of those faraway, long-ago medieval times. And like all good writers, she made herself the central character of all of them.
I am Rachel, daughter of Asher Ben-Zvi of Clairvaux, in the land of the Franks. I have traveled the face of this earth, and I am a very old woman now. And I have come back here to be buried with my ancestors. I have been a slave, and I have been a queen. And I have found good points in each. I've been away for many years. No one even remembers why I left. I'm not even sure they know who I am. But the rabbi and his wife shelter me out of the goodness of their hearts. Poor folk, they have little enough as it is. And yet, it could have been so different. So different. I write this chronicle to show how different the world could have been. And so, I shall go back many years to when I was a young girl in my father's house here in Clairvaux.
Rachel?
Yes, Father?
Isaac is here.
Isaac here? No. But doesn't he know it's bad luck to see one's bride before the ceremony on the wedding day?
You'd better talk with him, my dear.
Something's wrong.
Well...
What is it?
Oh, nothing, I hope. That is, I hope it's nothing more than the natural feeling of apprehension that so many young men feel on their wedding day.
Father, something's the matter.
I just thought I'd come in here to prepare you for... Well, you'll just have to be patient with him. Isaac, please come in here. Now remember, child, he needs understanding.
Isaac?
Hello, Rachel.
I know that you both will excuse me.
What is it, Isaac?
I don't think we should get married.
Well, are you trying to say you don't love me?
No. I love you.
Well, then...
Rachel, have we the right to marry? To bring children into the world? Look, this world?
I think this is the only world there is.
You know how difficult, how dangerous life is for us.
Yes?
If only we could fight back.
We're too few. We're weak.
I know. It's only... Oh, Rachel. I was not born to be a scholar like my father, or a doctor like your father, or a craftsman. I have no skill with copper or silver or gold. I was meant to be a soldier.
A soldier?
Yes, I have skill with the sword and the bow.
But you cannot be a soldier. The law even forbids you to carry arms.
I know.
You must submit to whatever the Lord has in store for you.
Yes. But why did the Lord give me such an appetite for fighting and no way to satisfy it?
Well, suppose you were permitted to become a soldier. You speak of how uncertain life is now. Imagine how almost everybody in the army dies in the war.
At least you die fighting.
Well, is that so important?
Yes, it is. To me.
Well, I still want us to be married, Isaac.
Then, Rachel, we shall be married tonight.
I still want us to be married, Isaac. With those words, I condemned him to death. I pronounced the sentence of doom on my beloved. And I changed the course of my entire life. Had I not insisted on marriage, I might never have left the village of Clairvaux. There's no point in thinking about that. After Isaac had left, my father came back into the room.
And what have you decided, my child?
We will be married. But, Father, is it the wise course?
It is the only course. Our mission is to survive.
Father, I'm afraid. Afraid for Isaac. He has a quick temper.
It's true. He refuses to be humble.
And it's because he has too much strength.
Oh, no, child. He hasn't strength enough. Anyone can strike out in anger.
Oh, Father, if only...
Yes?
I was about to say something silly. I was going to say, if only there was a land where our people could walk tall and straight.
No one walks tall and straight anywhere, except for a few nobles.
Father, who are the Khazars?
Why?
Well, I read of them in one of your books.
It is a kingdom. A Jewish kingdom.
Where?
No one can be sure. Some say Persia, some say Turkey.
A kingdom. A realm.
Well, perhaps it's only a fable.
But think how wonderful it would be, Father.
Rachel, in the first place, there is no way of getting there. In the second, it probably doesn't even exist. And now you must help your mother prepare food for the wedding feast.
Oh, yes, the wedding feast. I don't like to think about it, but if I'm going to tell my story, I must tell everything. All of us, everyone in our tiny community, had gathered in the courtyard of my father's house. Torches made the scene as bright as day, and Isaac and I were married under the stars. And there was much happiness and laughter and drinking of wine. When suddenly, there was a thunder of approaching hooves, and the lord of the castle, Count Ranulf himself, at the head of the troop of his horsemen, came upon the scene. Everything became quiet. So quiet, it could have been the stillness of death. Finally, my father stepped forward.
Greetings to your highness, Count Ranulf.
I see you heathen dogs are feasting. What is the occasion?
Ah, a wedding.
Why was I not informed?
Well, your highness...
No, this will not do. It will not do at all. And the bride, I see the bride. A rather good-looking girl at that.
Your highness, members of our community are permitted to marry if we secure the authorization of the bishop.
Bother the bishop!
But we have not violated any of the restrictions that are placed upon
to
our...
To think I almost missed this. A cup of wine, dog?
Oh, yes, yes, your highness.
And I was wondering how I should spend the evening. I shall have a most enjoyable night. Ludwig, a horse for the bride.
But your highness, where are we?
Where? To the castle, of course, where you shall spend the most pleasurable wedding night with me.
No.
You mean you refuse the honor?
Please, your highness, we have rights granted by the king.
Swine! How dare you? Are you unaware of the droit de seigneur? I have the right to spend the wedding night with every commoner girl who marries in my domain. Ludwig, put her on a horse.
No, never.
Only your youth prevents my mace from splitting your skull.
Would you talk to me this way if I had a sword in my hand? Coward!
And if you had a sword in your hand, dog, what would you do with it?
I would spill your heart's blood.
Oh. I like this one. Ludwig, he belongs to me. To me and no one else. Give him your sword.
No, please, don't. Don't. Your highness, I will go with you.
You shall go with me in any event. Well, now, Isaac, is that how they call you? You have your sword? Shall we fight?
To the death.
Oh, to the death!
Before I knew what was happening, the fight was on. At first, I thought Isaac would be cut to pieces immediately. But somehow, he had learned swordplay, and he was holding his own. And then, a miracle. He was beginning to press the Count. And on Count Ranulf's face, I could see fear as Isaac was slowly but surely overcoming his defenses. I knew that this cruel and arrogant man would never let Isaac get the better of him, even if he had to call for help.
To the death, Count Ranulf! To the death! Ludwig! Carolus, kill him! Kill the dog!
No! And the Count's retainer fell upon Isaac. It was a terrible sight to see. I remember I fainted. I didn't know anything until I regained consciousness. I was lying on a couch in a large room. There were tapestries on the wall. And I knew I was in the castle.
I see you are awake at last.
Oh, please, I... Oh,
but... What's to be frightened about? You'll be all right.
Who are you?
Hedwig, I'm supposed to prepare you for your lordship's bedchamber.
No.
Nothing will probably happen.
What are you saying?
Well, you know the state he was in. Furious. Your young man would have killed him in hand-to-hand combat.
Isaac is dead.
The Count had to call for help. At that, it needed five of his men-at-arms to do it.
Oh, I must go to him.
Go to him? He's dead, isn't he? Now I have to take you inside to my lord and master's bedchamber.
No.
You can't keep saying no. It isn't ladylike. Now listen. If I know Count Ranulf, he's so drunk by now he's going to be fast asleep, dead to the world. So you just go in there.
No! Kill myself first.
There's no need to kill yourself. Aren't you listening to what I'm saying? He's out cold. Now, tomorrow morning, before he wakes up, you walk out. And I'll see that the guards will let you through.
But
he won't remember that nothing happened. He won't remember a thing. But just keep your head. Now, come. Come in. You see, there he is, sprawled on his couch. Listen to him. There, behold the great lover, dead to the world. He can sleep like this for days.
You're going to have a very dull night.
Where are you going? Don't leave me, please.
I'll have to lock you in. But I'll open the door at dawn to let you out.
Oh, don't go. Please don't go.
A shame you didn't bring anything to knit.
Don't leave me alone. Don't leave me.
Le droit de seigneur, the right of the lord of the manor. This is how it was under feudalism. And so, here is our terrified Rachel, who only a few short hours ago was a single girl, and in rapid succession has become a wife and a widow. She's locked in the room of the Count Ranulf, whose intentions are perfectly clear, provided he sobers up. I'll be back shortly. We've had a rapid series of events. We've been listening to the story of a medieval writer, a woman who lived in France in the 10th century. On her wedding night, the lord of the manor killed her bridegroom and took her to his castle, where she now awaits his pleasure. That was a pretty usual state of affairs during the 10th century, in most places.
I was terrified. Even in his drunken sleep, his face was arrogant, cruel, a face without mercy, a man incapable of kindness. I thought about what had happened within the space of just a few hours. Isaac, my bridegroom, dead at the hands of this devil in human form. And I, not just bereaved, but disgraced. And then suddenly, my fear vanished. In its place, I felt a cold resolve. I would kill myself. It was the only way out. I would kill myself. His dagger was lying on a bench near the bed, a dagger with a jeweled hilt. And silently, I removed it from its silver scabbard. Thin, sharp, deadly, gleaming steel. It would be the work of a moment to plunge it into my heart.
Rachel. Rachel.
Who is that?
My dearest Rachel. Have you forgotten me so soon?
Isaac.
Yes. Isaac.
My husband.
Your husband. Your murdered, martyred husband.
Isaac, it's you. And you're alive.
No, I'm dead.
And why do I hear you so clearly? No, you're alive. I hear you. Oh, why can't I see you?
I'm dead, Rachel. Dead. Avenge me.
Avenge you?
Oh, Rachel. Be like Judas in the tent of Holofernes.
And then I shall kill myself.
No, no. Fly from here.
Where could I go?
To the land of the Khazars. A people like us. But a warrior people.
A warrior people. But our people haven't been warriors since the days of King David.
The Khazars are warriors. It is said they have descended from the 10 lost tribes.
But what will I do there?
You shall rule.
Me? What do I know about...
You shall be a queen.
I'm dreaming. I'm having a nightmare.
No. You are awake. Listen to me. Go. Go to the land of the Khazars.
I don't even know where it is.
To the east, somewhere.
How can I find it?
If it is the will of God, he will show you the way.
Oh, such a journey. And the lands are filled with bandits and thieves.
God will protect you.
No, I'm frightened.
Had I lived, you would have gone with me.
Oh, Isaac, let me die, and I will come to you.
What are you saying? To take one's own life is a terrible sin.
But my life is of no use to me now.
You have a destiny. You are to become queen of the Khazars.
Me? Queen?
Why not you?
But I have no desire.
Find the land of the Khazars and make it a place where all of our people may take refuge. It's your destiny. But first, kill him. Avenge me. It takes only a moment, and it is done. See, just below the chest, and to the left, slightly to the left. I will guide you, my beloved. I will guide him.
No, not while he's sleeping.
Were he awake, you could never kill him.
Oh, Isaac. You must help me.
Yes, I shall help you. Hold the dagger tightly. And now, raise it high, and with all your strength, down! Cover him. Cover him with a blanket. Yes. Who would know he is dead?
How quickly a man dies.
How quickly I die. Goodbye, Rachel.
No, no, stay. Stay with me.
I cannot stay with you, Rachel. I'm dead.
Come back, Isaac. Come back. Speak to me. Isaac. Isaac.
Girl, wake up.
Isaac.
Oh, there's no point bellowing after Isaac. He's dead and gone. You've been lying on the floor all night. Is this how you slept? On this cold stone floor?
It was a dream. Isaac was a dream. Oh,
get up. On your feet, girl. Time you were leaving. Like I told you, nothing would happen, didn't I? Well, didn't I?
Yeah, you told me.
Hey, that's funny. I never heard him like this before.
Like what?
Quiet. He usually snores like a drunken pig, which he is. But he's lying there, still as a corpse. Maybe he's sick. No, I better not do anything. He hates to have people wake him. He might even plunge a knife into me. Come.
Where are you taking me?
I told you last night you can go home.
Home? But I'm in disgrace.
What kind of disgrace? You're not the only one. Besides, you're a woman.
I killed him, Father. I killed
him. Quiet, quiet. It would not be well for this to be known.
I heard Isaac's voice.
You must hide in my brother's house in Marseille.
But I promised Isaac that I would search for the kingdom of the Khazars.
There is no such place. It's only a fable. There are no such people.
But, Father...
You must obey me. You will go to the house of my brother Benjamin in Marseille.
Marseille. A city of Greek sailors in the country of the Franks. I would go, for Marseille was on the sea, and there I could take a ship and search for the land of the Khazars. The journey to Marseille, as all journeys are, was long and difficult and perilous. But I wore the clothes of a young man, a poor young man at that. I was so small and so slight, so humble and unimportant looking that nobody noticed me. After some weeks, I arrived at the home of my uncle Benjamin.
Well, my child, your fame has preceded you.
Fame?
You killed the mighty Count Renoff.
Then... it wasn't a dream.
Oh, no, indeed. You must keep hidden, of course, till this all blows over.
But I'll bring danger to your house, Uncle Benjamin.
We have so much now. A little more won't matter. You must keep wearing that boy's costume. It's a good disguise. And it's best all round for you to be mistaken for a young man.
Uncle Benjamin, I know how hard the times are. I don't want to be another mouth for you to feed.
Oh, there's enough and to spare. I am very much in demand here. We are really quite comfortable.
In what do you trade, Uncle Benjamin?
Maps, charts.
Maps? Of what?
My girl, this is a city of sailors. They come, they go. Their ships move in and out of the harbor like flights of wandering swallows. They need maps to show them the waterways.
Where is the land of the Khazars?
And why would you want to know that?
Because it's my destiny to go there.
your destiny?
To become queen of the Khazars.
And how was this destiny revealed?
My dead husband appeared to me and spoke to me and said I was to become queen of the Khazars. My father, of course, dismisses it as a fable.
But you are an honorable child. If you say a thing, why should any deny it?
Tell me, where is the land of the Khazars?
I don't know, but I will ask.
Who?
The sailors who come into my shop. Surely one of them will have heard of it. Meanwhile, you have work to do.
Work?
Yes, work. If you are to be queen, you must prepare yourself.
How?
You are just a girl from the country. You must acquire wisdom so that you will be a good ruler.
But how may I acquire wisdom?
By reading books. We have many books in this house.
Oh, Uncle Benjamin, I simply can't stay here and just read.
And while you are reading, I shall be making inquiries.
I became lost in my books. The more I learned, the more I discovered how little I knew and how much I must study. A year went by, 2 years, perhaps even three or four, I can't remember. As I say, I was lost in the books. And then one day, while sitting quietly and reading, I heard my uncle's voice.
Child! Child! Come out here!
Yes, Uncle?
Sit. Olaf, this is my nephew. Child, this is Olaf, the Viking.
You wish to know about the land of the Khazars?
Yes.
A wild and dangerous country. A fierce and warlike people.
And how could I get there?
If you will look at the map, there is this place that lies between the lands of the Persians and the Turks. Wild country. This, they say, is the land of the Khazars. But why should anyone want to go there?
Why? I've taken a vow.
Oh. Well, then I can only wish you good fortune. Benjamin, I shall leave this map for your nephew.
Oh, yeah.
And you may put it down on my account. A pity, young man, a great pity.
Why do you say that?
Well, they're a strange people, and yet they are suspicious of strangers. It would be better if you were a woman.
Why? Why would it be better?
As I have said, they do not welcome strangers, but they do have great respect for women.
Oh?
Especially for women who have wisdom.
Wise women?
Yes, yes, because only women have time to acquire wisdom. The men are too busy fighting or trading. And so when a king, or any man for that matter, wants to take a wife, he does not look for beauty, as we do, but for wisdom.
There you go. Destiny. Destiny. It seems to be leading the way to its own fulfillment. So far, everything our Rachel has done has taken her a step further along the road. But the perilous journey is still ahead. What shall await her once she arrives there? Well, I shall arrive with the third act in just a few moments. Listening to a story being told by a medieval writer, Rachel of Clairvaux. It is by now an old legend about this fabulous woman who was born at least 1,000 years before her time. It is the story of an incredible journey, and the boat is about to sail.
For the first time, I believed it. I believed I did have a destiny. I was meant to go to the land of the Khazars and to become queen, to make that land a haven for my people, my oppressed people. Olaf the Viking left the map with my uncle, and then the two of us put our heads together. How was I to get there? But the map shows us exactly where the place is, Uncle.
Yes, I see. But the journey...
The journey?
The sea is full of pirates. You shall be captured and sold as a slave.
If it is the will of the Lord I fulfill my destiny, then I shall arrive safely.
I will find you a ship.
And he did. The captain was an old friend, and Uncle Benjamin persuaded him to take me on as a cabin boy. For although it would be best to be a woman when I arrived at my destination, it would be better if I were a boy before I arrived there. My ship sailed. She was bound for the Greek city of Constantinople, and those waters were thick with pirates, pirates from every known nationality. But somehow, we seemed to have a charmed life. We outsailed most of the pirates who pursued us. And finally, after many weeks, we arrived at our destination. Then I took the trail overland, for I had many miles to travel. And yet, though it was the wildest of all countries, I had no fear. I knew it was the Lord's will for me to come to my destiny. One morning, I was weary, I was hungry. I passed by a field where some men were tending their sheep. I could hear their voices, and the words they spoke had a familiar sound. It was Hebrew, the Hebrew of the Old Testament. I was here. I had arrived at the land of the Khazars. And soon I was in a town, and there was a splendid house, and I knocked at the door because I needed food and shelter and a place where I could dress to become a woman again.
Yes?
I ask hospitality.
Oh, enter, young man.
Thank you.
From where do you come?
A far country, the land of the Franks.
Oh, I've never heard of it. How does it happen you speak our language?
Oh, I am one of you.
My name is Bathsheba, young man. What are you called?
Rachel.
Rachel? But that's a woman's name.
I am a woman. Where may I bathe and dress?
Oh, I never would have believed it. Why have you come here?
Bathsheba, I look into your eyes and I see you are a good person.
Oh, I try to be.
And I need a friend. Will you be my friend?
Yes.
I need someone to talk to. It's been so long since I could pour my heart out to someone.
Oh, I understand.
May I confide in you?
Of course.
I'm here to fulfill my destiny.
Your destiny?
I am to become queen of the Khazars.
Oh, well, then you've arrived in a good time. Even now, the king is looking for a wife.
That's true. What Isaac told me is true. I am to be queen.
Now, the queen must be the wisest woman in the kingdom. Are you wise?
Well, the Lord will give me whatever wisdom is necessary at the proper time.
Well, the king has proclaimed that he will marry the woman who can answer three questions.
Well, I'll know the answers when the time comes. What are the questions?
No one has appeared, and so the king has not yet asked.
Well, I shall go to the court at once.
Oh, one moment.
Why? Why should I delay?
Uriel! Azriel! Come in here at once! Lock her in the cellar!
Why? What are you doing? Tall, strong men seized me and carried me to a room deep under the ground. They locked the door and left me. And do you wish to know what was happening while I sat there, trembling? Very well, I will tell you. Bathsheba, my false friend, presented herself before the king.
Your Majesty, I have come to answer the three questions.
And what is your name?
I am Bathsheba, widow of Nathaniel.
Very well, Bathsheba. You're good to look upon. And if you are wise, you shall become our queen. The first question. How far is it from the sun to the earth? Can you give a truthful answer?
How far is it from the sun to the earth? Oh, Your Majesty, this is a difficult question. May I retire to make the proper calculations?
You have our permission.
How far is it from the sun to the earth?
I won't tell you.
Then you shall die here of hunger and thirst. Well?
Just
little water. Just a few drops, please.
Water, wine, cool, refreshing, all you want. Just answer the question. Give me the answer. Would you rather perish? The answer.
Will you let me drink?
Will you tell me the answer?
Yes, yes.
It is exactly as far from the sun to the earth as it is from the earth to the sun.
That must be accepted as a truth. It cannot be denied. Very well, Bathsheba. You are one-third the queen. Now for the second question.
Listen, what is it that in the morning crawls about on four legs, at noon walks erect on two, and at dusk creeps about on three?
I don't know.
You know. You know.
I don't know. I tell you, I just don't know.
Then stay here in this cellar. Starve. Die here in this cellar. My head was spinning. Had I come this far only to be defeated here by a false friend? Was I to lose everything? Was I to miss my destiny?
I resisted telling her the answer for as long as I could. It was a simple question for one who had read books. It was actually the ancient Greek riddle of the Sphinx. But I decided to die rather than tell her. But I was just too hungry, too thirsty. One morning I just... at the sight of food, I found myself talking and telling her.
What is it, then, that in the morning crawls about on four legs, at noon walks erect on two, and at dusk creeps about on three?
The answer, O King, is man.
Man?
Yes, man. In the morning, or the beginning of life, as an infant, a man crawls about on all fours. At noon, which is the prime of life and the time of strength, he walks strongly and proudly on his own two feet. And at dusk, which is the twilight of life, weak, decrepit, unable to hold himself erect, he hobbles painfully with a staff.
You are two-thirds my queen. And now for the final question. Are you ready, Bathsheba?
Yes, Your Majesty.
Can you tell me what I am thinking?
What are you thinking now?
What am I thinking now?
Oh, well, I...
Is the question so difficult for one of your great wisdom?
Oh, yes. Yes, Your Majesty. I must retire to study the matter.
You have our permission to retire.
Once again she came to me to ask me the question. And this time I said, I don't care. Kill me, starve me, do as you like. I cannot tell you the answer.
We shall see.
My dearest Rachel.
Oh, Isaac. Is that you?
Stop feeling sorry for yourself. I died fighting. Can't you fight?
How can I fight? All I can do is just starve to death.
No. You can fight this woman. Evil woman.
How? Tell me how.
Instead of weeping, why not open your heart and pray and ask for guidance?
I have no more patience. Give the answer now, or I will have my servants kill you on the spot. Speak.
How can I speak? How can I tell what the king is thinking? Unless, of course, I can watch his face and hear the tone in his voice as he asks the question.
That's impossible.
It can be done.
How?
Let me dress in your robes and cover my face with your veil. Then I could go to the palace and...
You take me for a fool? Do you think I can be trapped so easily? Once I let you go, you would never come back.
I promise I shall not try to escape.
Why should I believe you?
Because I am a religious woman. I cannot lie. I promise. I shall not try to escape.
Very well. We shall exchange clothes. Go in my place.
Bathsheba, you are ready to answer the third and last question. Can you tell me what I am thinking?
Of course. Your Majesty is thinking that I am Bathsheba, widow of Nathaniel, when in reality I am Rachel, daughter of Asher ben Zvi, from the land of the Franks.
What?
It is true, Your Majesty.
Remove your veil. Do any in this room know the woman Bathsheba?
She's not Bathsheba!
Silence, silence!
And now, may I withdraw?
Withdraw? Why?
Because I promised Bathsheba I would return. You see, she has held me prisoner in her cellar and made me furnish the answers to your questions. But to answer the final one, I had to come here. And I have given her my word to return.
You were the one who really answered the other two questions?
Yes, Your Majesty.
Then, you are the queen.
And so, I became queen of the Khazars, queen of a fierce and warlike people. I had hoped to find here a haven for all the oppressed of Europe, but it was not to be. The kingdom of the Khazars disappeared one day in flames and death, as all kingdoms do. And I, the queen, became once again a homeless wanderer on the face of the earth.
Say we never give you a happy ending. After all, we've told you about a lone, defenseless woman who lived during one of the most hazardous periods in history. And we've given her a full share of happiness, adventure, love, some sorrow, true, but ripe, contented old age. Could you ask for more? I shall return shortly. Centuries confined, restricted, exploited. And now, in our time, the bonds are breaking. Now women are rising. And what it signifies, we cannot say. After all, those who live through a revolution don't know it's a revolution till it's all over. What are women going to do? It's a proper question for us to raise. After all, we are the Mystery Theater. Our cast included Marian Seldes, Arnold Moss, Bryna Rayburn, Bob Caliban, and Court Benson. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown. Radio Mystery Theater was sponsored in part by CertainTeed Fiberglass Attic Insulation and Buick Motor Division. This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.